Okay, so hello, good people of Fedora world. My name is Jiří Vaněk, and I'm working as the part of the Red Hat OpenJDK team. And I'm going to tell you somehow quickly about the journey of the Fedora, of the GDK 11 to become the system GDK in Fedora. So there is an URL to the system-wide change if you want to read a lot of details about that. And if you would be interested in making the plain text presentation, that it's Vim Weakpoint Now, in Fedora, we have an OpenJDK. OpenJDK, since some GDK 6 is fully open source thanks to the project Ice-T, and OpenJDK is upstream of the Oracle JDK and have completely independent lifecycle on the Oracle JDK. That's very common error that people are saying that Oracle have end of life on some JDK, but that do not necessarily need to mean that the JDK itself is old. Now, JDKs in since its origins were pretty slowly moving gigantic snails, with the release cycle somewhere around 4 years. And the releases were pretty big, and there was the risk of the backward compatibility lost and the risk of the breakages, and people were waiting for the new features for a terribly long time. So the people around OpenJDK have decided to change the release cycle. We decided to change it to long-term support and short-term support versions. So all the releases before the JDK 9 were long-term support. And since JDK 8, there is always several short-time support versions and then one long-time support version again. So currently, the long-term support versions are JDK 8 and JDK 11. And the next long-term support will be JDK 17. All the versions in the between that are short-term support. In Fedora, we are harboring every long-term support JDK as a Java and version OpenJDK. And because to get review on such complex things as a Java is pretty complicated, we have one rolling package Java latest OpenJDK into which we are including every short-term support version. Now, if you look to the history of the JDK in the Fedora, they are visible. Several interesting gaps. The first one was JDK 6, which was for long time, for long 8 years. It was moreover the only JDK which everybody knows. Then, so it was the system JDK in Fedora for 4 years. In that time, the JDK 7 was alive for some time, but nobody had any trust in that. Well, in some time we put it into the Fedora anyway, but it was alive only for a few years. And then JDK 8 had become the system JDK in Fedora, and was the system JDK for another long 4 years. And there is a reason why, and that's the JDK 9 lost its backward compatibility. So we simply couldn't move to the newer JDK without actually rewriting half of the Java stack in Fedora. And that's now after 4 years, we hope that most of the Java stack is already adapted to the JDK 9 changes. So we decided to make the step and move the system JDK in Fedora to JDK 11. And we don't expect the delay with JDK 17. I guess we will put it here once it released. Now, why the hesitations? The Java have many known problems. It's exceptionally extraordinary language. But it has its burdens, and one of the never resolved issue is jar hell. That's something like your application is depending on the library A and on library B, but the library B is depending on a completely different version of library E than you would like to. There is no cure for that in Java world, and that's something what GDK 9 was trying to solve in the project Jigsaw. And well, its side effect was that we lost backward compatibility because Java have really a burden of of that everybody could access anything, and you cannot mind time that system forever without the changes of the internals. Most of that is cached in the runtime, in the compile time, but for example, reflection will byte in a runtime, and that was the main reason why we were postponing JDK 11 up to now, because these are bugs in the runtime, not in compile time. So, changes in the JDK itself and in the Java packages to make JDK 11 the main JDK in Fedora was pretty simple. So we make the patches and we make our copy repository and we launched the rebuild of the world, and 90% of the packages failed anyway. That was an unhappy surprise. So I was looking into the failures and find that it's not so bad as it seems. The half of them, half of the packages was dying because of the strict Java doc, and second half had hard-coded source and target versions of the bytecode, which was somewhere around the JDK 5. So the not even the Java compiler is six versions ago compatible. So we fixed most of that and launch another mass rebuild. On this, I forgot to notice that the Java doc generation was actually fixed by the changes in the Maven Java doc plugin by different people, by the JavaSig group where I am not a member, so that was community help, and thanks for that. So we fixed the target sources, we fixed the Java docs, and now only 50% of the packages was failing. That was pretty good. So I had published my work and asked maintainers to actually help to fix their packages. I have gathered most of the solutions to the most of the problems, and well, about 10% of the asked people actually made their fight and they have fixed their packages. And in that moment, we knew that we are green because there was about last 300 failing packages. In this moment, I would like to highlight one word. That's well, Fabio Valentini, who actually really was walking one package from another and to another package and to another package and was really fixing the remaining issues. I'm not sure how many hundreds of packages he fixed, and I think he is still fixing that. So thank you, Fabio, if you are around. Okay. Even he was somewhere in the middle of his work, we see that really most of the Java stack is working. So our work was merged into the main Fedora few days before the Fedora 33 branches. And in that moment, the main JDK in Fedora is system is JDK 11. So far, so good. Thanks to all packages who helped. Unlimited thanks to Fabio. And as far as I know, it's really is working fine and no issues are seen around. As I was saying, for the JDK 17, we will not be waiting so long, not delaying it without a reason. I hope to automate the source and target problem, probably by some new RPM macros that was discussed during the JDK 11 incorporated. But well, it was discussed and it was a little bit abandoned. Yep, that's all from me. If anybody have any questions, please go on and ask. Maybe I can answer to Neil. Then yes, I am member of the JavaSig group already, but I was not on the beginning of the Java 11 process because the JavaSig group was dead. And yes, Java 17, we really will put it no longer than in the first Fedora after release of JDK 17. Okay. Thank you very, very much.